Hello everyone, this is Carly Huang, Chairman of Digitimes. I talk to my friends many times. I have a dream in my mind. I say I want to study deeply about the US, Japan, China, Korea and Taiwan. We co-work and co-create so-called Asia-Pacific era. And, you know, I study in Korea.I live in America 2 years. I travel to about 100 major cities over the country in China. Absolutely, I live here. I was born in Taiwan. So, but only one space. I really need someone to help me to understand more things about the country, which is Japan.
Yeah.
I'm very happy and honored to have my special guest from Japan today, Professor Fujitsu Kendo-san. And I'm very happy, very honored to invite him to come. Please shake hands to our audience,
please. Yeah, yeah. 大家好, So I'm Kenzo Fujitsu.
Kendo-san, I believe people, if Taiwanese people know, you was born in Kumamoto.
Yes.
Yeah, I think most of people know where is Kumamoto now.
Yeah.
Because Kumamoto is a hot zone for Taiwan today.
Yes.
TSMC built a factory over there.
Yeah.I visited.
Yes. And, you know, this year, I mean, three or four weeks ago, I was invited by Semicon Japan as a speaker to Tokyo to give a speech to introduce how Taiwan developed semiconductor and high-tech industry. But one day before, we had a dinner in Ginza and discussed about the cooperation in the future. So we have the consensus about...how Taiwan and Japan can work in the future, can work together. So before we get into the business, I'm very happy to have you to discuss with me because you and myself all work for national project for high-tech industry in Japan and Taiwan as well. And I'm the guy, actually, I'm one of the writers of Taiwan's Computer Industry Development Plan. And I plan for Hsinchu Science Park as well. So I can say that I'm one of the witness of Taiwan's story. And I know you are the witness of Japan. You work for METI at that time.
Yes.
And maybe our audience maybe didn't know, Kendo-san also used to be the congressman. And he used to be the deputy minister of METI.
Yeah, not Minister of Communication.
A Minister of Communication, yeah. Okay. Anyway, there is a position to watch globally and internally, absolutely, we need to form a strategy for our country. So, first question, I would like to ask you a question about semiconductor. You know, this time when I paid visit to Japan, I was in the Semicon Japan and I was in the booth.Front of deputies, and I'm really curious. So many people and young men even, they watch deputies, listen to deputies people to introduce their strategy. I saw the passion in South Asia today.
Yes.
And what's different? You know, for many years, Japan almost skipped the new technology.About advanced chips manufacturing. But now looks like a new refreshing point for you. What do you think about the kind of things for? Can you give us some observation?
Yes. At first, I'm very happy to visit Taipei. So because my father was born in Taipei, Hsinchu.
Hsinchu?
Hsinchu, yeah. So before World War II. And also my son is working at the Academic Clinic.In Taipei.
中央研究院.
Yeah, so, and I would like to talk about the semiconductor industry situation in Japan. So now Japanese government very focusing on semiconductor industry, so revitalize semiconductor industry. But this is a very high challenge for Japanese government. So now,we are investment around 4 trillion Japanese yen on semiconductor industrial policy. However, so Now we have two projects. One is a Lapidus. So R&D on two nanometer semiconductor.
Yes.
And invite TSMC and Taiwan semiconductor industry to to Kumamoto.
Yes.
But in my opinion, we should make think about a global supply chain, not only Japan and Taiwan. So we should invite USA. So because when I was a senator of Japan around 5 years ago, so we have a regular meeting with a U.S. congressman.
Yes.
Yeah, so this is not closed. And the U.S. member, including Mike Rogers, who was a writer of CHIPS Act of United States.
Yes.
More than 5 years ago.
Yes.
And we talk about how to revitalize semiconductor industry with United States, not only Japan. So this is very big step. So this is secret story. For the first time, I disclose now. So we talk about CHIPS Act, how to make CHIPS Act in United States. And we also discuss how to catch up CHIPS Act in Japan. So yes. This is our origin of Japanese CHIPS, semiconductor industry program. And U.S. government, U.S. Congress established, concluded CHIPS Act in military related act. Mm-hmm. And the next we follow up, so U.S. government. So this is a closed story.
Yes.
So I think now at first we can make a collaboration between Taiwan and Japan at first.
Yes.
And in near future, we should invite United States to our circle.
Yes.
So because in 1990s, so I was working at Ministry of Economic Trade and Industry.
Yes.
And I was in charge of semiconductor industrial policy.
Yes.
Yeah, but however, so in 1991 to 1995, so my job is negotiation with USTR and the USDOC.
Okay.
No new technology.
Yes.
I'm very stressed by this job.
Yeah.
So because I joined Ministry of Economic and Trade Industry to make new industry. I'm a member of Electronic Industrial Division at the MITI. And I was working more than 70% for negotiation with the US government. Yeah, but at the time, we should select collaboration with the U.S. government, so we can make a different way. So at that time, we discussed about the second semiconductor agreement between U.S. and Japan.
Yes.
Second stage.
Yes.
And we get some share of U.S. semiconductor market, but this is not good. So this means no competition.
In 1980 or 1990s, the status of the global economy are different from today, right? In 1990s, normally we need to rely on American economy.
Yes.
Second, PC, personal computer industry is the most important industry at that time. Mm-hmm. We need to follow because the branding companies like Intel, Apple, Microsoft, they define the business way. They define the spec of semiconductor even. So we need to follow. But after year 2000, the status was changed because China economy become one of the powerhouse. Second, fortunately, I say we are lucky. Taiwan become a critical player because, as you know, most of the advanced chips produced by Taiwanese makers now.
Yes.
So Taiwan play a very important role